Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to take your Zoom meetings to the next level using your Android device as a second camera and be able to switch between the two in the Zoom platform. Let's do this. Welcome back to the channel. As always, if you're new here, please hit the subscribe button. What we're going to do today? Well, I'm going to show you how to use your Android device, could be a tablet, could be your phone, and use it as a second wireless camera in the Zoom platform. The possibilities are endless. It's got loads of uses. Ideally, I use it for teaching or demonstration purposes on the surface of a table or a desk. What do you need to do this? Well, you need an app on your device. I'll show you what that is. It will be linked below. And you need a program on your PC. Again, that will be linked below. These two together link up to talk over your home Wi-Fi, and all then you need is something to hold the device and to be able to angle it down. What do I use? A simple tripod, a simple mobile phone holder, that's it. Let's get into it and let's show you how this is done. So what you want to do is on your phone, go to the Play Store. In the Play Store search, type Droidcam. It should auto-populate. You should see Droidcam wireless webcam. That's the one you want. Click on that. Mine says on there open, but yours will stay installed because you've not installed it yet. So go ahead, install it. Once it's installed, go and find it and click on to enter. Once in there, you'll see this screen that opens. What you're bothered about is the Wi-Fi IP address and the Droidcam port. Make note of them. We're going to use them a second in the Windows client. So take a note of them. We'll go into the Windows client now. So here we are on the PC. Open up a browser, go to Google or whatever you want to use and search for Droidcam. That's what you want. Dev 47 apps. That's the website. Click on that. And it will bring up this page. Now you can actually download the app there. There's a link to download the app. However, all we're after is the Windows client. Go ahead, download the Windows client. Depending on which PC you're using, it will download. Go to the download, save, open, whatever you need to do. And then go to your start menu and search Droidcam to open up the Windows client. There it is. And there you'll see two boxes, one for the IP address and one for the Droidcam port. Enter the details that you made a note of from your phone, enter them into there. Then you've got two options, video and audio. If you want to use it for audio as well, go ahead, that's your preference. Once you're ready, just click start. And there we are. Wireless cam, ready to go, all set up, stick it in your tripod or wherever you're going to set it up, and you're ready for now to open Zoom. And we're going to do that now so I can show you how to select it once you're in Zoom. Okay guys, I just wanted to show you the setup within Zoom, how to get your Droidcam, your mobile phone cam, your second camera, however you're setting it up to show. And it's pretty simple. In the settings on your screen down here, there's no need to share a screen because you're not sharing an actual screen. What you're doing is changing your camera input. So at the moment, what you're seeing on the screen there is coming from the webcam. That's what I usually use. I don't usually use this. This is because I'm recording through a different software. Usually use a microphone that's integrated into the webcam. So that's your normal camera. This is what's selected down here. However, if you go in there, now I've set up my mobile phone, it's recording with Droidcam. If you go in there and in your camera sources, you'll see all the different camera sources you've got to use, which you could draw on. That's what I mean, you could have three or four, however many you need. But all you need to do is go down to Droidcam. I don't know why it's got two and three. I might have set it up twice. but you just find the one that's set up ready to go. Switch it over. Obviously the audio is still used from your primary audio, and if it's not, you can still select it down here. Where do you want it coming from? Choose your audio. You could have it coming out of your mobile phone if you want. If you could, you could just use it directly as the camera if it's better than your webcam. That's how you choose it. You just use it directly as your camera, no problem. And you do what you need to do. Whatever you need to do. And then go back to your normal cam, switch it back. And there you go. Lots of, if you haven't got a tripod, you can get someone to hold it, because it is wireless, obviously. It's not like you're, get someone to hold it for you up above. I don't know how you could make an overhead cam without a tripod or getting it facing down. You can get them quite cheaply, but there you go. That's how you set it up. Switch this back now, making me sick. So there you go.
There you go. You're now set up to use a second camera in Zoom. Whether you use this professionally or for fun, the tools are there for you to improve your online Zoom experience. Keep watching, guys, a lot more to come. Hit the subscribe button, give us a like, and if you want to be notified next time I release a video, hit that bell button. Question for you, let me know in the comments how you plan on using this feature. For now, guys, thanks for watching. Look forward to next time. Goodbye.